Manya Sadasagan, I'm calling Mr. Vaiko. His name in the list is below, but as our honorable leader of opposition suggested, I'm just calling with the consent of all. Please.
Mr. Vice Chairman, sir.
Sappu there. Please.
The great Tamil moralist Tiruvalluvar has stated that gratitude is the best virtue in human's life. Payan thookar seitha udavi, nayan thookin nanmai kadalin peridu. Reverend Father G.U. Pope translated like this: kindness shown by those who weigh not what the return may be, when you ponder right is merit, it is vaster than the sea. I owe my gratitude to the leader of the DMK, Dr. Karunanidhi, for sending me here in 1978, 1984, 1990, and to his ablest son, now this time the leader of the opposition, Mr. Stalin. Those days when I entered this house, I was a new member. I didn't have any legislative experience, but I was mesmerized by the roaring of Mr. Bhupesh Gupta, like a lion. And Mr. N.G. Ranga used to sit there and encourage youngsters like me. And Mr. Pillu Modi used to encourage, I saw the such stalwarts, to encourage new members. And even if the clock goes beyond 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, Mr. Bhupesh Gupta and N.G. Ranga, one Sivachandra Jha of BJP, they used to sit here till the time is over, till the house is, till the doors are closed. I learned lessons from them. That is the duty bound lessons. Sir, this is the second chamber. At the same time, it is the upper house. It is the upper house of the parliament. There have been times to minimize the role of this house. Financial matters do not figure very much in this house, but the best finance ministers, Mr. Dr. Manmohan Singh, Mr. V.P. Singh, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, Mr. Yashwant Sinha, they came from this house. Many used to insinuate and criticize that this house is a distant cousin of Witans of Anglo-Saxon times and offspring of Chelmsford Act of 1919 and little relevance in free India. In fact, many a fine private member, many members in the Lok Sabha, many private member bills and resolutions were brought to abolish this house in the Lok Sabha. But legislators in the Lok Sabha, having their infinite and abundant wisdom, had trashed such attempts into a dustbin. It is a permanent body. Rajya Sabha has performed the role of revisory chamber. It has defeated few bills and amended the classes of many bills and accepted and in the Lok Sabha. It has gone one step further, introducing an amendment to the Constitution, 44th Amendment in 1978, as an example. I don't want to take much time of this house. This is my experience. Those days when I was a youngster, the senior members used to sit here up to 10 o'clock, even 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Nowadays, it is very difficult to get 2 minutes, 3 minutes. For that, we have to crunch like a beggar. I'm sorry to say, to crunch like a beggar, 2 minutes, 1 minute, 3 minutes. After 24 years, this is my experience, my only one demand. I support my friend Mr. Patil. This should become the upper second chamber of United States of America. Then only true federalism should usher in this country. Equal representation to all the states in India. Equal representation to all the states in the Council of States, in the Rajya Sabha. Then only true federalism, true democracy could flourish. I hope I am concluding.
Thank you. Thank you.